need to go in there. That's where she's controlling it from. Mr. and Mrs. Pryor. So Fitz, I just called you Fitz. Tony, President Fitz. I've heard you say before that when you sit down the scandal cast to read the scripts, you guys are like screaming audience members.
That's
just
true.
Get excited. Did that happen for you at all with Divergent? Because you guys have some very intense roles to read the script and we're like, whoa.
I was blown away by the script.
Yeah, when I read the, yes, exactly. That was what hooked both of us.
It started as a very poignant family story in this really womb-like milieu of abnegation. And then all of a sudden it got launched into an exploration of a allegedly utopian society that we get the sense is starting to come apart at the seams. And then all of a sudden it became this rite of passage odyssey.
Yeah.
Right.
And it just really went crazy in a great way.
It's
from
like
there.
A rocket ship.
Yeah, exactly. It was a thrill to read.
Right, which I love. And there's some, I don't want to spoil it for those who haven't seen the movie yet or have read the books, but obviously your characters have an interesting arc. And one of my favorite parts of the film is the very emotional scene in the Abnegation House before the choosing ceremony. Yeah. And they're very, like, you can tell that they want to do more or maybe cry or hug them some more, and it's just very reserved. Because that's their faction. Mm-hmm. And I'm wondering, is that similar to you guys in real life, or are you like waterworks?
Waterworks. Base?
I'm more the waterworks.
Waterworks.
Yeah. My
bring on the waterworks.
Me. Yeah.
Which I love that about you, by the way.
Oh, thank you.
I love that about you.
Yeah, I'm gonna be a mess at my kids' weddings. That's just not gonna be, they're gonna be so embarrassed.
Okay, so not that like, let's do one hug and go to bed. That's not you guys.
And I think waterworks are really important for me, and what I notice is, if I start to become irritable, or my personality gets big, or I let trifles interfere with my serenity, there are actually tears under there somewhere. Mm. And it's about having the openness and the vulnerability to get to the tears, and then afterwards I'm like, exactly. Mm.
It's just refreshing.
Right.
That was so deep. Man, I feel like I need to go cry now. Just let it out.
Let's just all have a group
you
cry. Come on.
Thank you. Yes. Very selflessly. You guys will take care of me.
Love, what are you doing here?
I knew they'd assign you here sooner or later. Look at you. God, you're so strong and beautiful.
Mom, you can't be here.
I know, but you're in danger. I have to ask you something. You weren't sick the day you took your aptitude test, were you?
Why?
What were your test results?
They were inconclusive.
Divergent. You can't tell anyone. You can't tell your friends, your instructors. You can't trust anyone. People have always been so threatened by divergence. But now Erudite is looking for them everywhere. They're actively seeking them out.
Why?
Well, what am I?
So, just kind of a random question that I've found interesting. If you had to be basically trapped, like a lot of these characters are trapped in Chicago, basically. If you had to be trapped in one city for the rest of your life, where would it be?
City?
Why?
Well, the name of the city for me would be H-E-L-L. Any city for me would be hell.
Mm.
You trap me on a mountaintop and I'm good.
And you're good to go?
Mm.
Okay. See, I love cities. I love mountaintops too. I would have to be New York.
New York.
Yeah.
All right. Fair enough. So maybe not trapped together.
You. We wouldn't be able to work together.
I don't see that'd be a problem.
I won't trap you then.
I'll come on the mountaintop with you. I could do that.
Wilderness. Well, congratulations. I think people who already love the books are going to be very impressed and very pleased. And people who haven't read the books are going to go read them.
Yeah,
because
right.
they love the
right.
movie. So
I think you're right.
We'll see you at the premiere.
Yeah.
With the screaming fangirls.
I just picked out my dress today.